Yo, this is me again, and it's time for Global Martial Arts. After trying hard, Fang Ping and Hin Fengking finally arrived at the entrance gate of Hope City. Fang Ping reported that he had lured the high-quality warriors to King Jiao Forest and had a plan to kill that high-quality warriors. The leader of the army Wu guarding the entrance gate knew that Fang Ping and Hin Fengking were in trouble and currently being chased and wanted to be killed by the high quality warriors. But Fang Ping and Hin Fengking managed to escape and even lured the high quality warriors into King Jiao Forest. Because they came back with a lot of good things on their backs, a soldier told that Fang Ping and Hin Fengking had robbed the house of high quality warriors. The leader then requested that the entrance gate should be opened. However, because Fang Ping and Hin Fengking were wearing cave human's clothes, the soldier who guarding the entrance gate thought to play a little prank on Fang Ping and Hin Fengking. One soldier recorded the incident of his son that being beaten by Hin Fengking until he couldn't get out of the bed for more than 15 days. Another soldier recalled how Fang Ping blackmailed his nephew for 30 million. Otherwise, the soldier's nephew Wu sent to Wu Wen school in Small Wu would be sent into the cave by Fang Ping. Another soldier also said that he was blackmailed by Fang Ping for 20 million. When the entrance gate opened, Hin Fengking was a little surprised that many soldiers were welcoming. Fang Ping then felt that it was a form of welcome for the human race heroes, because killing high quality creatures is a great achievement. But Hin Fengking's wishful thinking was shattered when one of the soldiers shouted that there were two cave warriors who broke into the city. He also invited other soldiers to capture Fang Ping and Hin Fengking. This made Hin Fengking and Fang Ping very surprised and made such a funny expression. Fang Ping then asked, "Are these people are Hin Fengking's enemies?" Because he had offended so many people and couldn't remember who he had offended, Hin Fengking only could answer that he didn't know the soldiers in front of them. Fang Ping then shouted that if they really had a grudge, then go ahead and rebuy it. But, however, he and Hin Fengking were not on the same team. all of you satisfied. And like this video, please subscribe, share, and like my video. And if all of you wants to appreciate my work, please don't skip ads in the video. See you on the others video. Bye.